Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, good night, whatever time you're watching this. Today, I want to introduce a little bit the topic of etymology by showing you one of my favorite etymologies, which is the etymology of the word pedigree. You might know, if you're not an English native speaker, you might know the word pedigree from the dog food brand, Pedigree. It's very common. You also have it in China and Vietnam and I think almost all over the world. Now, the dog food brand is named after the word pedigree, which means a genealogical table, so a table of ancestry in the English language. Which kind of makes sense because for dog breeders, the ancestry was very important. But where does the English word pedigree come from? Well, it comes from French first. Pied de grue, which means foot of a crane, the animal crane. So why is a dog food brand named after the foot of a bird, you may ask? All right, let's find out. In the medieval ages, a three-forked sign was used to indicate ancestry in manuscripts. And this three-forked sign resembles very much the foot of a crane, or actually any other bird too. The foot of a crane has three toes and one very little toe that you don't see well. Okay, that makes sense. Here we have the connection. We have the toe of the crane, which resembles the sign for ancestry, which was used in the manuscripts, and that's why they named it Pied de Grue, which became Pedigree. But we can trace it back further if you want. We can take the word apart and look, for example, at the word pie, foot. In Latin, it's pis, and this goes back to the Indo-European root word pied, which you can find in many other words today in English, French, and other languages. German, of course. For example, we have the words pedicure, centipede, expedition, pawn, which was a foot soldier. He had to walk by foot, peon, podium, and also impeachment, although it's a little bit less obvious. Now let's trace back the word crane or grue, pied de grue. The French word grue comes from the Latin word grus, and that comes from the ancient Greek word geranos. And there are other words in apparently not related languages, Germanic languages, that sound very similar, like grus, gru, gere, gera, gera, and so on. And there is a theory that it comes from the sound that the bird makes, but that remains to be proven. And finally, the machine crane also comes from the same root because the bird crane has a long neck and that resembles the machine. All right, I think there was a lot of information in one little word and you find a lot of connections to other words, to other languages and to the history. I hope you enjoyed and I hope I could convey a little bit why etymology is so interesting and rewarding and also good for learning languages. See you, bye bye, tschüss.